Hey guys, welcome back to Less Expensive Fix. So today's video, we're still working on Infiniti G35. I know we've been working for this car for so long because those cars, they have a lot of issue. So my issue now is the C1142 with the EBS pressure sensor. I have a problem with that. And if I've been talking all time about the U1000s issue, so that one specifically, if that you have an issue with that one, can cause the U1000s because it's EBS system. So now, well, every time I park the car really high like that, when I put my car and when I get reverse, I start the car, I get the car reverse, the car jump, like you hear like clacking noise. So this gives sense, like when you press, the sensor is the for pressure EBS system, like when you push the brake, and that is the pressure. If you have an issue with the pressure, that one caused that problem. You feel that clacking noise hard. Plus, when the car is cold in the morning, and when you start the car and when you drive, what happened? First gear, second gear, jump, the car starts slipping. So that cold can cause the transmission to lose in communication until the transmission figure out is nothing wrong there, then the car start drive normal. But before first gear and second gear, you feel the car jump and jerk like crazy. So what gotta do now before I change that sensor, because that sensor is not available in AutoZone Advanced or already. You have to buy from the dealer directly. This wire is required from factory only. This Infiniti Nissan manufacturer. So before I change that sensor, I have to change my differential fluid, because the last time I put regular fluids, I put 80-90 regular fluid. This was required for the car normally, but you can use full synthetic 75-90 with LS formula. So we gotta go to the store and see if I can find the formula why I'm looking for. If not, I gotta go to the shop and use the fluid I have in the shop. So stay with me guys, and don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to see more tricks. Stay with me. So for the code guys, is this one here. There's the ABS pressure sensor, is this one here guys. This is the C1142 for Nissan Infiniti. This is for G35 and Nissan 350z. And make sure guys, always the fluid is full. If you have the fluid is low, can cause that car too. And this way it can cause the car be slipping. So for the C1142 EBS pressure sensor, for the C1141 is the power steering pressure sensor. So it's too close guys. This way guys, make sure we check everything in the car. If the fluid is low, or you never, sorry guys, if you never flush your brake fluid, sometimes you have to flush the brake fluid. If the brake fluid is not correct, you have to pressurize, you have to vacuum everything and remove all the fluid from the brake system and put a fresh one. And if you have any air in the system, can cause that problem too. So guys, I've been looking for this problem. Now I have no choice to buy the part from the dealer only. Like that will make sure you get something factory, because I know Nissan, Infiniti are quite only dealer part only. So first thing I do, I check the differential fluid, the differential fluid. And we have to use 10M. Let's remove the flush. There you go, the tools. And we're gonna do open the, already loose them a little bit. I lose the top one. Last time I put 80-90, so now I gotta put full synthetic for any slipping things. Look good. The main thing is this ball here, because it has a magnet. We're gonna see if there is a miller shape there. Yeah, there is a lot of miller shape. So we're gonna put synthetic oil, 7590, Formula LS with the limited slip. This is different between the regular fluid and full synthetic fluid. Synthetic fluid coming with a limited slip on the car. After that, we're gonna check the exhaust, make sure the exhaust doesn't leak. Okay, the fluid we're using, 7590, full synthetic, limited slip. So we're adding fluid, and we'll make sure they stop a little bit. Keep dropping like that. Then we close. So like that is fine. And we close it. So guys, after I changed the differential fluid, the car drives smoother. And I still have to change the brake pressure sensor, because when he shifts the gear, sometimes if the car is up or something like that, you feel the shifts hard. So the sensor, that one, need to be changed. So guys, if you like this video, please like, share, and subscribe to the channel. Like that, we keep showing you more tricks. See you guys.